So we went to this promoter, and he said, well, I'll set you up with this guy. His name was Jose Lothario, and, you know, even that time, Jose, you know, to him, it was just a business thing, a way of making money. $3,000 and all that, I'll train you. I said, okay. Or my dad said, okay. Obviously, I didn't have $3,000. My dad's like, hey, he's already getting $3,000. Started with Jose, and before long, he was telling people, this guy's gonna, it's gonna be something. He trained me 2.5 to 3 months, and he just said, I think you're ready. Bill Watts came to me and said, you know, you need to move on. So I'm gonna send you to Kansas City. I'd been there for just a couple weeks, and I was sitting in the locker room. I never really talked that much. Guy came up to me and he said, you know, I see something in you. He said, it's just dying to come out. He said, but you don't have anybody to get it out of you. He said, I'm gonna get it out of you. And that guy was Marty Jannetty. And he was the guy who ended up being my tag team partner and unleashed what was inside of me. I stayed up in Kansas City for about 3 months when Jose called me and said, you know, we've started a promotion down here in San Antonio. You can come home, you can be paid, you'll be at home, and we're gonna make you the guy, your hometown boy. So I said, well, that sounds great. Jose and I put a tape together. We sent one to the WWF and one to the AWA. But the AWA, Marty Jannetty had just gone there. I thought, this is a sign. I jumped on it, moved up there, and met Marty, reestablished our friendship, and Marty and I started together. And then one day, Pat Patterson saw us on TV. It was on the ESPN channel at the time, so we had finally gone nationwide. We got the call, we'd like to maybe give you a job. We went to the WWF the first night, we didn't have a match. That night, everyone's inviting us to go out to the club. No, 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 we're not gonna do it. We're gonna need to be strong. Finally, one of the people that actually worked for the company, an agent, said, no, you need to go and do this. You need to get to know the other guys, mingle with them. So we went to the hotel / nightclub where everybody was at. And up walks this guy, hey, here you guys are, big partiers, come on. We said, no, 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 we're not doing that now. And he bites into a glass and chews it up. Come on, punks. Finally, I grabbed the glass, I said, all right. And I broke it on my head. The next day, we come into the lunchroom, and up comes the guy we, you know, was chewing glasses the night before, walks up to my partner, Marty, and says, what's your problem? And Marty thought he was joking. And we said, what are you talking about? What's your problem, yada, yada. Then he starts telling this huge story of how we tore this bar up. And by the time night came, Marty and I had torn this place to shreds. And all these guys that were in there saw it. Never happened, but that was the story. And we have a match that night, and we have a tag team match, and one of the guys is that guy, and another guy. We're so scared. So we go to Chief J. Strongbow, who the first day walked up and said, I don't like you guys, didn't want you here, don't want you to stay here. He was very honest with us, and that's Chief. He talked to him, the guy went out there, it was business, the match went off without a hitch, went spectacular. As we're leaving, Vince McMahon says, hey, you two. I said, yes, sir. I said, let's watch that stuff in the bar, okay? Does his Vince laugh and leaves. We leave and we go, okay, well, obviously he knows, but it's okay. Week later, we get a call. Flew up to the old office. So we're out there sitting with our wrestler, you know, jeans and snake skin boots on. Vince comes walking, I says, nice boots. He says, well, thank you, sir. They're made for walking, you know. We're like, oh, Jesus. Come on in, just kidding. Brought us in, then he fired us. Yeah. And he said, look, I believe your story. And he said, you know, trust me, I'm doing you a favor. We'll get, you know, go somewhere else, maybe in a year or two, give us a call, we'll think about it. So, we made a call to another smaller promotion in Tennessee. As fate would happen, now we're going back and forth between the AWA still there, they want us back, so we're going in between both. We're back to being World Tag Team Champions again in the AWA. And all this has happened over a year's time. Now I'm 23, Marty's, you know, 26, 27, and just out of the blue, we say, let's try to give him a call. So we called him up and I said, well, have you learned your lesson? Again, and yes, we have, please, one more chance. begged for forgiveness and said, okay. And we came into the company, and then we arrived at the company for which I presently work now. I was put on a certain path, and now I look back and I say wrestling was only a part of it. I used to think that wrestling was the major part of it. But wrestling was the path for me to get to my wife and to my son, and for that to lead me to Christ, and then for that, I think, to lead my family, and who knows after this. So that's in the hand of God, not me, and I just follow now.